So let's see the eyelids. So eyelids, they are upper and lower and are movable contents which protect the eye from the foreign bodies and the bright light. They keep the corners clear and the moist. The upper eyelid, it is larger than and more movable than the lower eyelid. The space which is present between the eyelid is palpebral fissure. The two eyelids are fused with each other, form a medial side and the lateral side. So that is called the medial canthi or medial angle, and that is called the lateral canthi or lateral angle. At the inner canthi or the medial canthi, there is a small triangular space. So this one, it is called the lacus lacrimalis. Within it, there is the elevation called the lacrimal coruncle. So this one, which is made from the modified skin and modified gland. Then lateral to that, the coracle, the bulbar conjunctiva forming a pinch upwards and form a vertical fold. So this one, it is called the plica semilunaris. Then each eyelid, it is attached to the margin of orbital opacity. The free edge is broad and has a rounded outer lip and the sharp inner lip. The outer lip present 2 to 3 rows of the eyelashes, except the boundary of locus lacrimalis. At the point where that is the eyelashes are absent, so that is forming the lacrimal papillae. So this one. Then on near to that, the inner lip, a free edge, there is a rows of opening of the tarsus gland. Then the structure of the eyelid. So it eyelid, it is made up of the skin, which is very much thin, loose and easily distensible and inflamed by the edema of the fluid or the blood. Then the superficial fascia is without fat, and the palpebral fascia of the two lids forming the orbital septum. Its thickening forms a tarsus plate. So here in the another diagram, you can see that is the violet color. So that is called the tarsus plate. And this tarsus plate, it is the upper tarsus plate and the lower tarsus plate. And it is attached, upper tarsus plate, it is attached to that the palpebral ligament. The tarsals are a thin plate of condensed fibrous tissue. The upper tarsus, it is attached with that the muscle levator palpebrae superioris. So this one. And then apart from that is the usual gland, that is the larger glands are present. So first, that is the large sebaceous gland, that is also called the Zeiss gland, at the lid margin associated with that the cilia. This one. Then the modified sweat gland, or that is called the Mott's gland, at the lid margin closely associated with that the Zeiss gland. Then the sebaceous or the tarsus gland. So here that the opening is present. So that is the opening of the tarsus gland. So these are also known as the meibomian gland. So this gland, that should be present into that the upper lid and the lower eyelid. Then the blood supply of the eyelid, that is the superior and inferior palpebral branch of ophthalmic artery and the lacrimal artery. Then the nerve supply, that is the upper eyelid to whole bulbar conjunctiva, supplied by the supratrochlear and the supraorbital nerve, and the lower eyelid by the infraorbital nerve. Then the lymphatics, that is the medial halves, drain in the submandibular lymph nodes and the lateral hulls, that is drain into the preauricular lymph nodes. Then the venous drainage, the veins that should be drained into that the ophthalmic and the facial vein. After then, let's see, that is the conjunctiva. So conjunctiva, it is a thin transparent mucous membrane which lines the inner surface of the eyelid called the palpebral conjunctiva and the front of the sclera. It is called the bulbar conjunctiva. The potential space between the eyelid and the eyeball when the eye is closed, it is called the conjunctival sac. The lines of reflection between the palpebral and the bulbar conjunctiva above and below forming the superior fornix, this one, and the inferior fornix. Then the palpebral conjunctiva is highly vascular and firmly adherent to the tarsus plate. On the other hand, the bulbar conjunctiva, it is loose over the sclera but firmly adherent to that the cornea, forming the anterior epithelium, that is called the corneal epithelium. The conjunctiva consists of the mucus secreting gland. Then next to it, that is the conjunctival sac filled with the three films of the fluid. That is, first water from the lacrimal gland, the mucus from the conjunctiva, and the oily secretion from the tarsus gland. Then the blinking movement of the eyelids makes these films moisten cornea and helps to drain the conjunctival fluid into that the nasal cavity. So that is the conjunctiva. Then the clinical points related with that the eyelids and the conjunctiva. So first point, that is the chalazion. So here this is the chalazion. It is the inflammation of the tarsus gland and it causes the localized swelling on the inner aspect of the eyelid. So that is called the chalazion. The next clinical point, that is the sty. So it is a suppurative inflammation of the Gis gland which is present into that the eyelid. In this condition, that the gland is swollen, hard and the painful, and the pus points near the base of the cilia. Hence it can be easily drained by plucking the cilia. So that is the sty. Then the blepharitis. So it is the inflammation of the eyelid, mostly involving the lid margin. So this is called the blepharitis. Then the examine the palpebral conjunctiva. So that is the examination of the palpebral conjunctiva. Physician help to diagnose the anemia, and the bulbar conjunctiva, that is help for the diagnosis of the jaundice. Then next to it, that is the inflammation of the conjunctiva, that is called the conjunctivitis, and that should be occurs due to the infection or the allergy, is one of the commonest disease of the eye. The trichoma, it is a granular conjunctivitis caused by the trichoma virus, and it is very much contagious and considered as a commonest cause of the blindness in the India. So these are the two clinical points related with that the conjunctiva.